Two of my favorite charts that were not listed in the flow chart are tables, or simply just text, and maps. A table isn't traditionally thought of as a tool for visualization, but sometimes if your data doesn't have any inherent structure or order, a table is the most natural choice. Tables typically are used to represent summaries of data or somewhat disjoint facts. In this example, we'll be looking at states and their corresponding state bird. Since states do have some geographical representation, we may want to represent them on a map, but since state bird is simply a label or category, it may be hard to represent in one of the other visual encodings that correspond with the geographic map. Typically with a map, you have either the size or color of some geographic region or some points to plot. In our case, we simply want to look up which state and find the corresponding state bird. Tables work well when there is no inherent relation between the data you're conveying. Since we simply want a state to state bird mapping, we can use a table as something of a lookup mechanism. Maps are interesting because they are something of a compound visual encoding. A map is simply an x and a y coordinate combined with some geographic context, often in the case of latitude and longitude, and when combined, we get a mapping of an x and a y pixel coordinate to some latitude and longitude, which equals a map. I quickly wanted to go over one of my favorite visualizations due to its simplicity and power by Dustin Cable from the Weldon Cooper Center for Public Service. With this visualization, we have many visual encodings going on in the same space. Every point on the map is actually one person from the US Census. The color of the dot corresponds to their race as reported on the census. And the X and Y pixel position of the map correspond to the latitude and longitude of the census block from which the person reported their race. What's truly stunning about this visualization is that nowhere in the graphic are state or city borders drawn. The natural structure of the United States and the population density across the United States naturally falls out of the fact that every dot represents a person, and most of the people in the United States are reported on the census. The map we have drawn here only uses two visual encodings, the X and Y coordinate for position, and one visual encoding, the color, for the race. There are just a few other geographic charts that I wanted to talk about. A choropleth map represents some value by color and plots it geographically across a region. Typically, you may see this as states of the United States, which have a different color representing the intensity of some value. Going back to the previous example of unemployment, we might represent the unemployment of every state as some range of colors. A map that's very similar to a choropleth, but uses a different visual encoding to encode its value, is a cartogram. A cartogram represents some geographic data and uses the size of the geographic region to encode often some continuous value. Again, going back to the unemployment example, rather than representing the unemployment rate of a state by its color with a choropleth, we can represent it by the size of the state's geographic region that we draw. And just reviewing what we just covered with the dot map, a dot map could actually represent any shape. In the case of the example I've shown, it was similar to a scatter plot where we represent our data with circles and how it corresponds to some geographic change. The map we just went over is an interesting combination of a choropleth and a dot map in a way, since it uses some geographic data with a shape, in our case, a circle, and some color to encode another secondary value for each point. And as always, there are many other chart types that I'll not cover here, but are typically some sort of compound chart in the way a choropleth or a cartogram combines elements from two simpler chart types. In the resources section of the class, you can find an exhaustive list of most every common chart type that people use